Good day again, students. So we are now in our third week, our discussion in media and information literacy. Okay, so in this module, so we are now in the evolution of media. So just like as humans, as what you learn in your science, the theory of Charles Darwin, I think they remember that, the theory of evolution. Okay, so how humans evolved through time. Okay, so it's the same concept. So in this topic, so we will learn how media evolved from the prehistoric age to this modern times we have today. Okay, so this lesson is very interesting. So I hope you will watch this video presentations. Okay, let's have our lesson one, evolution of media, traditional to new media. So are you aware of what is happening in your community? Are you still updated with the current issues that our country is facing today? So what issues do we have, do we face today? Okay, it's about COVID-19. So lucky for you, you are still alive, because many of our countrymen are suffering from COVID-19, especially those frontliners. Okay, so as a student, as our contribution, so we must stay at home and avoid crowded places so we'll not be infected with this disease. Okay. Okay, if you're APS, good to hear that. I bet you have your cell phone, televisions, or radio with you to stay updated on what is happening around. Did you ever wonder how people in the past received and delivered information or data? Okay, so you try to imagine. I think you'd not. I hope you watch some movies of how people communicate before. Okay, so during my time, so I was born in 1986. So I witnessed the evolution of especially the computers and cellular phones, okay, or the cell phones we have today. So during my time, it was not so that high tech like we have now. We have our smartphones are already touch screen. Before, during my time, especially 90s, so it's not, it only uses keypad. I think you're familiar with Nokia, so that's the famous cell phone during my time. Okay, but now, we have now plenty of brands, okay? So, I can relate to this evolution of cell phones also. So this can relate this to our topic this week, okay? So what's in? So activity one again. So you will answer this in your Microsoft Word answer, then send it to my account. So we have plenty of activities in this module. So just you just put it in a one Microsoft Word file. Okay. So I will flash the email account on the screen. Okay, picture analysis. Analyze a picture and answer the question that follows. What does a picture tell you? Explain your answer. This picture here, side. So you analyze what do you mean by this picture, or what do you understood in this picture. So are you familiar with the technologies that they use? Well, those are some of those technologies that they use for communication. It was difficult and complicated to communicate before. It was challenging and time consuming. So with the development of technology, people today receive new tools that make them more efficient and effective. Okay, let's find out more. Okay, what's new? So, okay, again, you have another activity. Answer this. So directions, classify the following communication tools according to what age they belong. So we have here Okay, paintings, transistor radio, smartphones, motion picture, typewriter, portable laptop, clay tablets, mainframe computers, television, paper rules, telegraphs, woodblocks, Facebook, newspaper, CD projectors, and Google. Okay, so you try to sort these words here in these columns. Okay, we have here these headings. So, which do you think these words belong? Okay. So again, answer this in Microsoft Word. Put your answers there, and email this to me. Okay. Okay. So were you able to get all the answers correctly? Okay. The words that you have classified are some of the communication tools that were used in various ages in the history of communication. Industrial age, electronic age, and new information age. Okay. Okay. So to have a glimpse of the history of communication, so let's watch this video presentation by Vogue.com. Okay, so I hope you get something from the video presentation about the history of communication. Okay, so let's have here a discussion of our lesson. So what is it? So as media and information evolved throughout the history, it provided people with a better and faster access to information that is easier to adapt and to manipulate. Okay, below are different tools that were used in various eras in the history of communication. So let's have this pre-industrial age. Pre-industrial age, before 1700s, people discovered fire, developed paper from plants, and forged weapons and tools with stone, bronze, copper, and iron. Okay, so examples, we have cave paintings, also known as parietal art, are numerous paintings and engravings found on cave walls or ceilings around 38,000 BCE. Okay, the photo is from Encyclopedia Britannica. Then we have another, clay tablets are used as writing medium, especially for writing in cuneiform. Cuneiform is one of the oldest forms of writing. This means of communication was used over 3,000 years in different languages. Another, we have papyrus. It's made from peat of papyrus plant. It is used in ancient times as writing surface to designate documents written on its sheets rolled up by scrolls. Other examples, so Acta Diurna in Rome, Dibao in China, Codex in Mayan region, and printing press using wood blocks. Okay, that is in pre-industrial age. Now let's go to industrial age. So this is 1700s to 1930s. People use the power of steam, develop machine tools, establish iron production, and the manufacturing of various products, including books, through printing press. Examples, we have printing press, specifically used for text. It's a device that applies pressure to an ink surface resting upon a print medium. And another, we have telegraph. It's used for long-distance communication by transmitting electrical signals over a wire laid between stations. Okay, you see, as you can see in this picture. And we have motion picture, also known as film or movie. A series of still photos on film projected in a rapid succession on the screen by means of light. Okay. Next. Other examples, we have newspapers, typewriter, telephone, motion picture photography, commercial motion pictures, motion picture with sound, then punch cards. Then another, so this is the third age, the electronic age, 1930s to 1980s. The invention of the transistor ushered in the electronic age. People harnessed the power of transistors that led to transistor radio, electronic circuits, and the early computers. In this age, long-distance communication became more efficient. The example, this is transistor radio, large computers, and main computers. So other examples, we have televisions, personal computers, then LCD projectors. Then new age, we have 1900s to year 2000. The internet paved the way to faster communication and the creation of the social network. People advanced the use of microelectronics with the invention of personal computers, mobile devices, and wearable technology. Moreover, voice, image, sound, and data are digitalized. We are now living in this information age. So example, laptop, Facebook, Google Meet. So I think you're familiar with this age because this is our age today. So other examples are presented in this side. Okay, let's have this. Before I will discuss this part, so let's have again another video presentation. This is now about the history of social media. So if you wonder what is the first social media platform, okay, so let's have this video presentation. So are you ready?
Social media. Everyone we know uses it in one way or another. Whether it's to organize an event or to delete those drunk pictures from the night before, it has made an impact on everyone's life. But where did it come from? Give us a few minutes and you will know. It could be seen that the first type of social media first hit the mainstream in 1997 with blogging. The internet had hit 1 million websites and AOL introduced a chat function so that users could communicate across the globe with their instant messaging service. It was then, in 1999, that Friends Reunited was introduced to the family computer and could be seen as the original Facebook. People could connect with old school friends, look at their pictures, and communicate through messages. Friends Reunited was seen as one of the first social networks to stand the test of time. With more than 70 million computers connected to the internet, we saw the introduction of Friendster in 2002. This website at its peak had more than 100 million users. The following year, we saw the start of MySpace, a clone of Friendster, but this website would stand the test of time. MySpace allowed for editing profiles, whilst also having the ability for bands to showcase their music gaining fans through a breakthrough form of marketing. This saw the music industry change as a whole from this point on, with bands such as Arctic Monkeys and Lily Allen famously being found on the website. 2003 also saw other forms of social media being introduced, such as podcasts, Flickr, an image hosting website, and LinkedIn, a social network for professionals. Then, in 2004, the social network that everyone is aware of today was launched. Facebook was created at Harvard College and was known to the students as their own Friendster. Whilst Facebook was progressing in the background, MySpace overtook Friendster in page views, which saw the start of the decline for the website. In 2005, Bebo, an acronym for Blog Early, Blog Often, was started as another social networking website. Similar to other social media websites, you were able to connect with people, viewing their pictures, and later creating little apps and quirky ideas to separate it from its competitors. YouTube was also brought to light, where for the first time, there was a website where the general public could store and retrieve videos. It was in 2006 that Twitter was launched, a micro-blogging site which lets members send and receive tweets. Not only could they tweet their friends and family, but now there was a way to get closer to celebrities. You were able to read what they were doing and even communicate with them, breaking down the barriers between them and the fans. MySpace continued to grow and became the most popular social networking site in this year. With MySpace and Bebo continually growing, Facebook became worldwide, and in 2007 introduced apps. During 2008 and 2009, with a quarter of the Earth's population using the internet, we saw the rise and fall of many social media websites. Bebo and Friends Reunited were rebranded, bought and sold by many companies, all of which failed to keep up with MySpace, Twitter, and Facebook. Facebook surpassed MySpace with its figures of the monthly unique visitors. The press were starting to see the effects of the micro-blogging site Twitter and how fast it could break a news story. From 2009 to the present day, we have seen new additions to the social media world, all looking at different aspects of the industry. Websites and apps have been launched, including Tumblr, Pinterest, Google+, WordPress, and Instagram, just to name a few. Having such an increase in social media websites, some of the original social media, including MySpace and Bebo, have had to redesign and relaunch their product to compete. Those which could not adapt, such as Friendster, have ended up shutting down completely. Social media is now a vital part in people's and businesses' day-to-day life. With Facebook now having over 1 billion users, and with the introduction of smartphones, you are now always connected. The business world is now adapting with their brand visibility. By encouraging their customers to join them on Facebook or tweet us, you are buying into their brand. It is also now the quickest and easiest way to get the latest news. With tools such as Twitter, as soon as something happens, it will be on there. Certainly faster than waiting till the 6 o'clock news or going to the corner shop the morning after. God, imagine that. Of course though, there are always negatives with new technologies. And with this area, the main issue is privacy. Signing up to all these websites provides the big companies with the opportunity to find out everything about you. And with their terms and conditions, they own all of your documents and pictures, allowing them to use these away from your control. Treat social media like your grandparents. Anything you would be embarrassed to show them probably shouldn't be shown to the world of social media.
Okay, we have our functions of communications. Functions of communication of media. So number one, monitoring function. She is to inform the citizens on what is happening around them. The number two, information function. This is to educate the audience on the meaning and significance of the facts. Number three, opinion function. This is to provide a platform for public discourse. This is to facilitate public opinion and expression of dissent. Four, watchdog role of journalism. It denounces the wrongdoing of the government and private, which leads to increasing of accountability and spearheading positive changes. Then number five, functions of media, channel for advocacy of political views. Okay, so again, another activity for you. So media at four ages. So I want you to write in the various age. So what did people use to communicate to each other in this age, industrial to new age? Then how do people send or store information in this column? Then the third column, we have the what did people use to share or broadcast information. Okay, so again, you submit this using a Word document and email this to my account. So you just compile it in one Word document, activity 1 to 5. Okay. Then activity 4, traditional versus new media. Again, answer this. Then explain, write your write on the line which of the two is traditional media and new media, and explain briefly. Then last activity, we have the Venn diagram. Okay, so you answer this. Give the similarities and differences between traditional media and new media. Okay. Okay, these are the key concepts we have learned. To sum up, so let us remember, as media information evolved throughout the history, it provided people with a better and faster access to information that is easier to adapt and to manipulate. As a media communication tool, it is used to inform people on what is happening around them and educating people to make significance of facts. Media is also used as a platform for public political discourse, which can form public opinion. Media also serves as a watchdog of the government and private agencies, which leads them to accountability and effecting positive change. Okay, so if you have questions, so you can again email me or PM me in Facebook for more clarifications. Okay, so let's have this lesson 4, indigenous media and other sources of information. So we have here another activity. So what's in? So direction to know more about this pandemic. Your task is to look for 3 news articles about coronavirus. Then write on the box the references you got your news articles and answer that question. Okay, so this activity. Okay, so if you have questions, you can email me in my account or through Facebook. Okay. So goodbye, class.